Quantum entanglement is absurd. How do particles that are millions of light years apart can still influence each other, and that too instantaneously, seemingly breaking the light speed barrier? This video will try to provide a fresh perspective of looking at it, and will also present you an entirely different solution to the entanglement problem. Let's begin. We've all heard of the entanglement story. Since the 1920s, quantum mechanics had been bringing all of our intuitions about how the world works. Particles don't have definite values of physical properties like position, velocity, momentum, and blah blah blah. And it is only when we try to measure what their state is that they instantly take one of the possible values of these properties randomly. They are our wave functions that give us the probabilities for something to happen if we were to measure it. Again, if there's no measurement, the particle remains in a superposition of all possible states. For example, in an atom, electrons occupy all of the probability space. They are not at any particular spot around an atom, unless you try to measure it, at which point you would probably find it at a particular spot for that instant. And Einstein was not a fan of this idea. However, experiments were kind of against him. Quantum mechanics is the most accurate representation of the world that we have, and so no one can dismiss it as one waving. But Einstein still felt like this can't be how reality works. There must be something deeper that we're missing out. Quantum mechanics had to be incomplete, and Einstein was not alone. Some other prominent physicists also shared his view, most notably Erwin Schrödinger. Ever heard of Schrödinger's cat? The idea that a cat can seemingly be both dead and alive at the same time? Well, that wasn't to popularize quantum mechanics. Rather, that was a criticism that Schrödinger had against quantum mechanics. Nowadays, though, it is frequently used to explain superposition, which is not what he meant. Coming back to entanglement, Einstein was trying to find a way to show conclusively that quantum mechanics, even though it makes really great predictions, must be incomplete. Entanglement was how he tried to do that. Though he didn't call it entanglement, it was Schrödinger. Suppose a particle with spin 0 decays into a particle with spin. Now remember, particles don't have different values of spin until you measure it. So these particles are actually in a superposition of all possible spin states. But then, angular momentum should be conserved, and so the values of spin must be correlated to give a total spin of 0, because that's what we started with, even if the particles are light years apart. Moreover, measuring spin of one of those particles would instantaneously influence the spin of the other particle to conserve angular momentum, and that needs to happen instantaneously, breaking the light speed barrier. And since in relativity, nothing can travel faster than the speed of light, this superluminal influence must not be possible, and thus, Einstein concluded, quantum mechanics shouldn't be complete. This is the EPR paradox, named after the three people that came up with it. What Einstein proposed was a theory of hidden variables. What if the spin states aren't chosen at the point of measurement? What if they were definite from the very beginning? This is where the shoe analogy works really well. Suppose I have a pair of shoes and I send one of them to you, and you know this. It doesn't really matter how far you are. The moment you get the shoe, you'll know instantly which one of the shoes I have. Did anything travel faster than the speed of light? No, because what shoe you'll get and what I will have was determined from the very start, from the moment when I separated them. Such is the proposal of Einstein's hidden variables. The outcomes of measurements aren't chosen at the points when they are measured. Rather, there's some hidden information, something that we're missing out on, information with the help of which it would be completely obvious why any particular outcome was observed rather than something else. So here we are at crossroads. Quantum mechanics describes a world without realism, without definite values for physical properties, and without locality, allowing for faster light influences, but something that we've found to work well with experiments. On the other hand, hidden variables describes a world that is real and local, but we don't really know what these hidden variables are. Now, we can agree upon the fact that the world promised by hidden variables is quite promising, but can we really test out the choices? Because the differences seems to be just about how we interpret the data and not about the data itself. We measured the spin of a particle and got a particular value. Did it have that value all along, or did it just got a value when we measured it? It doesn't seem like something that can be tested. Enter John Stuart Bell, and he had this really great idea. Suppose we have an entangled pair of particles. Then if we try to measure the spin of one of these particles, we have to measure it along any particular axis. For instance, if we measure the spin of the particle along the vertical axis, we would get a spin that is either up or down. But this measurement still tells us nothing about the spin along the horizontal axis of either of the particles. the spin along the horizontal axis is completely independent of the spin along the vertical axis. However, the spin states measured for the second particle along any of the intermediate axes would still be influenced to some degree from the original choice of measurement and its result for the first particle. But then this is only true for standard quantum mechanics. In hidden variables, the spin states along all of the axes is premeditated from the very start. And this provides us an opportunity to test between the choices. If we randomly measure the spin of the two particles along random axes at both ends, because in quantum mechanics particles do influence each other, while in hidden variables they don't, there are statistical results that show different levels of correlation. Bell derived an inequality that must be fulfilled by any of the hidden variables theory that describes our world. Turns out, in the Bell experiment, quite anticlimactically, quantum mechanics wins. In the real world, the Bell inequality is violated. The world truly is probabilistic, uncertain, and even non-local. Depressing as it might be. Now, I promised to give a fresh perspective, and here's the time for that. We find entanglement mystical because the world around us doesn't work like that. You will never see something here causing something somewhere else unless something travels from here to there. This is locality in a nutshell. But entanglement sort of changes it. Doing something here can change something somewhere else without something to travel from here to there. Whether or not something truly travels between the particles is debatable, since no information seems to have traveled between them. And that really tells us that entanglement isn't really about one particle instantaneously affecting another faster than the speed of light. Rather, when two particles are entangled, they are, in some sense, the same thing. It is not like doing something to one changes something about the other, rather, they are the same thing. Even mathematically, they are described as the same wave function and therefore should be considered one object. The reason it becomes weird is that in our day-to-day world, things that are separate in space are usually distinct things that are to a large extent independent of each other. In entanglement, even though the particles are separated by some distance, they are entangled enough to be classified as one object that behaves as a single system. And I agree that it doesn't really take away the problem that we have with entanglement. The problem is its non-local behavior. But that's the thing, quantum mechanics is non-local. And it is probably one of those things that quantum mechanics changes about reality. Now, even after all of these things that we've discussed, there's still a way out for the world to have definite properties and be local. But didn't Bell prove hidden variables wrong? Well, not quite. The Bell's inequality had an added assumption to it, something that seems like an obvious thing to assume. However, with all the things that we've seen bringing down quantum mechanics, can we really classify anything as obviously true? The thing being discussed here is measurement independence. It is the idea that the choice of the detector settings can be independently chosen to the things being measured, that the measurement apparatus isn't correlated with the particles being measured. And this need not be true. And by that I mean we don't really know if that's true. And an alternative comes from the idea of superdeterminism. Think about a world where the properties of particles, along with the detector settings and even the outcomes of measurements, are all predetermined. Predetermined on the basis of the detector settings that would be in place and even the results that those measurements would have. Superdeterminism is a kind of hidden variables theory in which the hidden variables themselves are correlated with the detector settings. And so, if you measure the spin of one of the entangled particles, it doesn't really have to tell that the particle what measurement has been done, because it already knows it, as everything is fixed. And thus, in the Bell experiment, it gives out correlated results similar to regular quantum mechanics. Most people have many problems with this idea. It takes away your free will, the freedom of the experimenter, and with that, the validity of science, or that it requires conspiracy. But the concern I have is that, what are these hidden variables we're talking about? Because there needs to be a bunch of them, and we really don't really know anything about them. Except that it is the hidden information that will allow us to make sense of it all. So, at last, we have to either accept a world that has non-local influences with uncertain properties of physical particles, or that there's some chance the world is super deterministic. The choice for now is truly yours. Thanks for watching.